guys, I'm Jackie, and in today's video, I'm going to be introducing my newest baby to my channel. I didn't film an unboxing for her because I just didn't get around to it. So I've had her for a little bit now. I've let her get settled in. So now I'm gonna film a video introducing her. So this is Envy, my female false water cobra, produced by Kyle Wilson. Her hatch date was August 8th, 2020, and I received her, I believe, September 8th or 9th, 2020, so right when she was a month old. She is currently eating small mice twice a week, and yes, you're supposed to feed them that often. I know it's crazy. And if any of my other snakes don't want to eat that day, then she gets extras. She never wants to eat when she's in shed. She gets really mad about it. She's super defensive right now that she's a baby and she's still getting settled in, and I upgraded her tank from her quarantine tank to her big girl tank, which is like about the equivalent, maybe a little smaller than a 40 gallon. Her tub, yeah. One thing they'll tell you about false water cobras that you won't believe until you get one is that their poops are rancid. I didn't believe anyone. I was like, oh, all snake poops rancid. Like, that's like, it's always disgusting. No, no, you don't have any idea. False water cobras, so stinky. Their poops are so smelly. It's literally like nothing you've ever experienced before. And trust me, if you can't stand the smell of snake poop with like normal snakes, do not get a false water cobra because they are smelly. She is so stinky. This girl shits worse than my boyfriend after Taco Bell. So you might see she's a little plain, she's a little boring. Like, why would I go out of my way to buy a snake that looks like this? She actually, within a few months, is going to look completely different. She is not going to look like the same snake. She has a little mask going on right there. I don't want to scare her. Like, her mask right here. Her eyes are going to turn black, and her mask is going to continue, like, all the way, like, inches down her body. She's going to get, like, a lot lighter in color, and her stripes are going to get a lot darker. So she's literally going to look like a completely different snake. I will insert a picture of what she looks like now versus what she will look like in a few months, just so you can see how crazy it is. Like, they literally look like a different kind of snake. I love the masks on them. They're so pretty. I love it. They look like little bandits. So a little bit about false water cobras. They are called Brazilian smooth snakes because of their smooth scales. And I'm not gonna touch her because I don't wanna piss her off because she's gonna start tail whipping everything if I touch her. So they're called Brazilian smooth snakes, and they are also called falsies in the pet trade. You'll also see them like abbreviated FWC, false water cobra, or just falsie. A lot of people just call them falsies. And you might think I'm crazy free handling a cobra, but this is actually not a cobra, hence the name false water cobra. The false is for the cobra, not the water. They live in the water, they are not cobras. They're named that because when they get really mad, they hood up like a cobra, so their whole right here will hood up, but they don't do it like this. Like a normal cobra, they go like that. So they do it horizontally, not vertically. However, they are somewhat venomous, so people are cautioned to be careful with them. However, they are rear fang venomous. So back here, just like Western hognoses, my tricolor hognose, garter snakes also. They are pretty harmless. However, if they do get the venom in you, your hand may swell up, you might feel like you have the flu. You're not gonna feel good if they get the venom in you, but you're not gonna die. There are absolutely no reported deaths from false water cobras. And even then, they're pretty reluctant to bite. And since the tooth is all the way in the back, like, how are they gonna get the venom in unless they chew you, right? And even then, it's meant for animals the size that they're gonna eat. False water cobras in the wild will range from eastern Bolivia to southern Brazil, and in Paraguay and Argentina. They live in wet, humid environments, and they spend a lot of their time in the water, hence the water in their name. They typically get between 6 and 8 feet long, the females on the bigger end of that spectrum, and the females will also get a whole lot heavier bodied. They will be chunky, and the males will stay pretty skinny. Some false water cobras reach up to 10 pounds, and those are the biggest females. So I hope she doesn't get that big because I am weak and I have no muscles. But I guess if she does, I'm gonna have to start going to the gym. Since these are some of the largest colubrids in the world, rivaling bull snakes and the eastern indigos of Florida, and they are very active diurnal snakes. Diurnal? Is that how you say it? They're very active snakes, and they are very big snakes. So they need a big enclosure. Most websites will tell you absolute minimum 4 foot by 2 foot. I would say go at least 6 foot by 2 foot, preferably even like an 8 by 3. That's what I plan to get her when she's older. That's gonna be her final cage, and hopefully a long time from now, because that's gonna cost a lot of money and it's gonna take up a lot of space. These guys will get sometimes more than 5 feet long in a year. So they grow really fast. They need a basking spot between 90 and 95 degrees, and their cool side should be between 75 and 80. These are from Brazil. They need hot, humid environments. Oh my God, my cat is fucking shit up. One of the coolest things about these guys, I think, is the range of food that they're willing to eat. Like ball pythons, half the time they don't even want to eat. But these guys will eat anything. They can eat mice, rats, birds, like chicken, quail, fish, fish fillets, frog legs, snake eggs, stillborn snakes. Some breeders will feed them to their false water cobras. So I bought some fun food for her so we can try that in the future. So stay tuned for a video on that, because that will probably be in a few months. So subscribe. Their food drive is insane, and I will insert some clips of her eating just so you can see like how crazy she gets when she eats.
Oh, you're so mad. Oh my God.
So this is exactly how you would find a false water cobra in the wild. This is a normal type, normal morph, whatever. They also have hypo and lavender if you wanted to get something fancy, but I just like the wild type because I think it looks cool, and I have a thing for normals if you've been watching my channel. I may or may not buy a male for her next year so that a few years down the line I breed them, but I wanted to get a feel for the snake species before I dive into getting another male. I didn't want to buy two and end up not liking the species enough to breed them. So yeah, that's everything I can tell you about my new false water cobra Envy and just a little bit about them. This isn't a care guide. Do your own research, but this is just what I can tell you about her from my experience so far. I've only had her since September, so I haven't had her that long. I do love her. I think she's so cool. So if you like this video and you want to stick around for Envy, leave a like to show your support. Comment down below for the algorithm, or, you know, if you want to leave a comment. And subscribe to stay tuned for more creepy crawly content. I hope we will see you in the next video. And with that, Envy says goodbye.